students, once again welcome to the LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Let's start with the course Mathematics 1 and same chapter indeterminate forms, but today's topic are zero, infinity by infinity form and 0 into infinity form. So first we will start with the form infinity by infinity, and first we will see the working rule to evaluate limit of the form infinity by infinity. So let's have a look how we will solve this infinity by infinity form. So if limit x tends to a f of x is infinite and limit x tends to a g of x is also infinite, then if limit given in the form limit x tends to a f of x by g of x, this limit becomes infinity by infinity. And this limit can be reduced to 0 by 0 form to apply L'Hopital rule by write down this g of x as 1 by g of x and this f of x by 1 upon f of x. So we know that limit of g of x is infinity, so 1 by infinity is 0, and limit of f of x is also infinity, so 1 by infinity is 0, so this form becomes 0 by 0. So if this infinity by infinity form cannot be reduced to 0 by 0 form even though we will apply L'Hopital rule. But if we can convert to 0 by 0 form, then we will definitely convert the given limit, that is given infinity by infinity form, to 0 by 0 form. And by applying L'Hopital's rule, we can calculate the limit value. Okay? So let's start with the example. Simple example, evaluate limit x tends to pi by 2 log of x minus pi by 2 upon 10x. First, let L is equal to limit x tends to pi by 2 log of x minus pi by 2 upon 10x. If we put the value of x is pi by 2 in numerator, we have pi by 2 minus pi by 2 is 0 and log 0 is undefined, that means infinite. And in denominator, 10 pi by 2 is infinite, so this is the infinite by infinite form. Now, as we have seen that infinity by infinity form can be reduced to 0 by 0 form, but I told you every time it is not possible to convert infinity by infinity form to 0 by 0 form. So, in zero infinity by infinity form, we can also apply L'Hopital rule. So, here we will apply L'Hopital rule, and we know that what is the L'Hopital rule? That differentiate numerator and denominator separately. That means differentiation of log of x minus pi by 2 in the numerator and differentiation of log 10x in the denominator. Okay, now again, now before putting the limit, just we simplify the term. So this x minus pi by 2, just going to the denominator, and sec square is 1 by cos square, so we can take this cos square to the numerator. So we have this cos square x by x minus pi by 2. Now if we put x is equal to pi by 2, then cos square pi by 2, we know the value of cos pi by 2 is 0, so cos square pi by 2 is also 0, and in the denominator pi by 2 minus pi by 2 is 0, so 0 by 0 form. So if in given limit directly we cannot reduce infinity by infinity form to 0 by 0, but after applying L'Hopital rule, it is ultimately the infinity by infinity form becomes 0 by 0. So don't worry about that. Now 0 by 0 form, so by applying L'Hopital rule, differentiation of numerator and denominator separately, we have this answer. And differentiation of cos square x is 2 cos x, and differentiation of cos x minus sin x, and in denominator differentiation of x is 1 and pi by 2 0, so 1 minus 0 is 1. Now if we put the limit x is equal to pi by 2, so cos pi by 2 is 0, and sin pi by 2 1, 1 into 0 is 0, so numerator 0, but denominator is 1, so 0 by 1, we know that some 0 by something is 0, so final answer is 0. This is a simple example. Now one more example, to understand betterly this infinity by infinity form, we have proved that limit x tends to infinity 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dash plus x square divided by x cube is equal to 1 by 3. So here we have to prove that the limit of this is 1 by 3. So let's start with the left hand side. So we have this left hand side. Here we can see clearly that if we put the value of this 1 square, 2 square, 3 square up to so on x square, we have one formula. Which is the formula? So we have the formula x into x plus 1 into 2x plus 1 by 6. Okay, so we have to apply this formula here. Now if we put x is equal to infinity in numerator, so we have infinity, and in denominator we have infinity, so we have infinity by infinity form. And in this example, no need to apply L'Hopital rule. If you apply, even though you will get the answer, same and right answer, and this method is also right, but if we can use school level limit, then if we take common x from this first bracket and if we take common x from this second bracket, we have this x, that means x cube, and we have x cube in denominator, so by cancel out, we have remaining part is this. And if we put x is equal to infinity, 1 by infinity is 0, so 1 plus 0 is 1, 2 plus 1 by infinity, 1 by infinity is 0, so 2 plus 0 is 2, 1 into 2, 2 by 6, that means 1 by 3, which is our answer. So here, no need to apply L'Hopital rule. And if you apply, even though you will get the same answer. Okay, now one more example. We have proved that limit x tends to infinity, x raised to m upon e raised to x is equal to 0. But here power m is positive. So let's start with the left hand side. If we put x is equal to infinity, so infinity raised to any power is infinity, and e raised to infinity is also infinity. So by applying L'Hopital rule, we have limit x tends to infinity m into x raised to m minus 1 upon e raised to x. Okay, that means differentiate numerator and denominator separately. Now again, if we apply, we will check. So this is infinity by infinity form. So again we apply L'Hopital rule. So again we have same rule, differentiation of numerator and denominator separately. So take power in front and one power minus. So we have this. And by doing this process same up to m minus 2 times, we have limit x tends to infinity m into m minus 1 into m minus 2 into m minus 3 up to dash up to 2 into 1. And differentiation of e raised to x is made infinitely time e raised to x. Now, if we put x is equal to infinite in denominator, and what is the value of this m into m minus 1 into m minus 2 up to 2 into 1, which is m factorial. So we have this m factorial by e raised to x, and if we put x is equal to infinite, e raised to infinite is infinite, so m factorial by infinite, and we know that something upon infinity is 0, which is our answer. Simple. Okay, now last example, the proof that limit x tends to 0 log of sine 2x base sine x is equal to 1. So let's start with the left hand side is this. Now here first we will apply the change of base rule in logarithm. Okay, so we have limit x tends to 0 log sine 2x divided by log sine x. If we put 0 in the place of x, so sine 0 is 0, log 0 undefined, that means infinite, same as the denominator. So here directly we cannot convert this infinity by infinity form to 0 by 0 form, so we will apply L'Hopital rule directly. So by derivative numerator and denominator separately, we have this, and differentiation of sine 2x is cos 2x into 2, differentiation of sine x is cos x. Now we can write cos 2x by sine 2x is cot 2x, 2 as it is. Same way, cos by sine is cot, which is also 0 by infinity by infinity form. Now here we can convert, because we know trigonometry can be convertible, so we can convert cot 2x by 1 by 10 to x, so 10 to x goes to denominator, and cot x 1 by 10, so 10 x becomes to numerator. So we have limit x tends to 0, 2 as it is, 10 x by 10 to x, which is 0 by 0 form. So by applying L'Hopital rule, we have 2 sec square x and 2 10 to x, differentiation of 10 to x is sec square 2x into 2. Now by putting limit value 2 into sec 0 is 1, sec 0 is 1, so 2 into 1, 2 into 1 by cancelling this, we have final answer is 1. Okay, so these are the example based on infinity by infinity form. How you can convert into 0 by 0 form? If it is not convertible, then directly we can apply L'Hopital rule. Now we have third form, 0 into infinity form. Now how we can convert this form to 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form, and how we will apply this to example, let's have a look on the working rule to evaluate the limit of the form 0 into infinity form. Okay, so first, to solve the problem of the type limit x tends to a f of x into g of x, to getting this 0 into infinity form, question is also in the form multiplication form. G of two functions are multiplied with each other. Okay, and if we have the limit of x tends to a f of x is 0 and limit of x tends to a g of x is infinity, then this form becomes 0 into infinity form. And by taking any of this function to the denominator, we can convert this 0 into infinity form into 0 by 0 form or infinity by infinity form respectively. And after getting this form, we can apply L'Hopital rule and we can solve the limit. Let's have a look on the example to understand this form 0 into infinity. So we have one example. Evaluate limit x tends to 0, x into log x. So let's have a solution. Let n is equal to, first of all, limit x into log x, which is 0 into infinity form. Why? Because if we put x is equal to 0 here, so this is 0, and log 0 is undefined, so 0 into infinity form. Now any one of the function we have to take in the numerator as the denominator. So this 0 into infinity form either becomes 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity. So let's take x to the denominator. So we have to write x as 1 by x. So both terms are same, but we have different form. And if we put x is equal to 0, so log 0 infinite, and in denominator 1 by 0 is infinite, so this form becomes infinity by infinity. And we know that in this form also we can apply L'Hopital rule. And what is the L'Hopital rule? Differentiation of numerator and denominator separately. So differentiation of log x is 1 by x, and differentiation of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. If we simplify, so x square goes to numerator, this x comes to denominator, we have minus x. And if we put x is equal to 0, we have final answer is 0. Okay, so easy. Same as we have another example. This example look like a big example, but think about the example and let's start with the solution. First of all, let this, and if we put x is equal to 0, x is equal to a, then a plus a 2a, but a minus a 0. So something upon 0 is infinity, and here if we put a, then a minus a square minus a square 0, 10 minus 0 is 0. So this form is 0 into infinity form. Here it is not easy to take any of the term to the denominator because it's become hectic. So first we will think and just remind the basic concept. We will apply conjugate form, conjugate logic. So if we take conjugate of this x a minus x, we have a plus x, a plus x. So numerator become a plus x whole square, and denominator become a square minus x square. And if we give this root separately, so numerator become a plus x and denominator become under root of a square minus x square. Now we can apply limit to this term separately, a plus x. So we have 2a, and we will take 2a outside of the limit, and we have remaining limit x tends to a, tan inverse of under root a square minus x square and upon under root a square minus x square. So you can see this is 2a and remaining term is this. Now if we put x is equal to a, this is infinity by infinity form, sorry, 0 by 0 form, okay. So we have 0 by 0 form ready. Now if we take under root x, a square minus x square is equal to y, and we will apply the limit, because if we suppose under root a square minus x square is equal to y, so we have to convert this limit value also. So where x tends to a, then this y becomes 0. So we have new limit is a into limit y tends to 0, tan inverse y by y. And we know the value of this is 1. So we have final answer 2a. Okay? So here also no need to apply L'Hopital rule, even though we have 0 by 0 form. Okay? Let's have a look on the another example. Evaluate limit x tends to 0, log of 1 plus x upon 1 minus x into cot x. Let's have a solution. Let L is equal to, first of all, now if you put x is equal to 0, so this log 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 1, 1, log 1 is 0, and if you put 0 in this place, cot 0, so we know that cot 0, that means 1 by tan 0, tan 0 is 0, 1 by 0 is infinity, so this form is 0 into infinity form. Now, here easily we can take cot x to the denominator, because we know that we have a trigonometry rule. So cot x become 1 by tan x, so tan x goes to denominator, and this form is 0 by 0 form. So by applying L'Hopital rule, differentiate numerator and denominator separately, we have this differentiation. Now we can cancel out 1 minus x, 1 minus x. Here minus x plus x cancel out, so remaining we have 1 plus 1, 2, and in denominator 1 plus x, 1 minus x, that means 1 minus x square. So 1 minus x square goes to denominator, and x square, that means 1 by cos square, 1 by cos square, cos square goes to numerator. So we have 2 outside, and we have limit x tends to 0 cos square upon 1 minus x square. If you put x is equal to 0, we have simply easy answer 2, because cos 0 is 1 and 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 by 1 is 1, so remaining only 2. So these are the examples based on 0 into infinity form. Same way we have this practice example that you have to do by yourself, that means do it yourself. If you do practice, then and only then you understand the next form, that means infinity minus infinity form, and the remaining the powers form, 1 raised to infinity, infinity raised to 0, and 0 raised to 0 form. So for that you have to keep practicing and keep watching. Thank you.